السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters, we will continue inshallah with the rules related to fasting. One of the rules related to fasting is using the siwak. Using the siwak. And the siwak was the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He used it while he was fasting many times, to the point that Amir ibn Rabi'a radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما لا أحصي يستاك وهو صائم. He said that I had seen the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم using the siwak many times while he was fasting, and I could not count how many times. That means that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used the siwak many times while he was fasting. So it's a sunnah actually to use the siwak, and it will not break the fasting. It will not invalidate it. One of the rules that is related to fasting also, and actually is connected with this ruling regarding the siwak, is the toothbrush and the toothpaste. Can we use them while we are fasting? The point is, if the toothpaste is very strong, has a strong flavor, and the person cannot control it and it will reach the stomach, in this case he should avoid it, because what leads to the prohibition, which is invalidation of the fasting, should be prohibited too. And as long as this toothpaste is going to lead to the invalidation of fasting, so it should not be used. But if it is such a type of toothpaste which is not that strong, that does not have a strong flavor, and the person will be able to control it and will not swallow it, will not make it reach the stomach, in this case, it should be allowed, and there is no problem with that. It will be treated like the siwak. So it all depends on the strength or the flavor of the toothpaste, whether it is strong and will be beyond the control of the person and will reach the stomach, or it will not be strong and the person can control it. The other rule which is related to fasting is using the creams for the skin and smelling perfume and the incense, which is a bukhur. All these things will not invalidate the fasting. Using the cream for the skin or smelling the perfume or the smell of the perfume, and also the bukhur, or smelling the bukhur, not inhaling the smoke of the bukhur, but just smelling the smell of the bukhur, will not invalidate the fasting. But inhaling the smoke of the bukhur or the incense will lead to the invalidation of the fasting of the person. So he should avoid it, because it will be similar to smoking. And that leads us to another rule, which is the rule of smoking in fasting. Basically, smoking is not allowed. It's haram to do it, to smoke the cigarettes or the vapes or anything like that, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of his main tasks, one of the main missions, one of the main duties and obligations that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had assigned our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to do, is to judge what is good as halal and to judge what is bad as haram. And this is mentioned in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَيُحِلُّ لَهُمُ الطَّيِّبَاتِ وَيُحَرِّمُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْخَبَائِثِ. So one of the missions of the Prophet ﷺ is to judge what is good as lawful and to judge what is bad as unlawful. And if we classify smoking, under which category we are going to classify it? Of course, we're going to classify it under the category of the bad thing. It is always bad. There's nothing good in it. And that's why, by the text of the Quran, it's not only makruh, it is not only disliked, but it is prohibited, according to the text of the Quran, that it is one of the main missions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to judge what is lawful, what is good as lawful, and what is bad as unlawful. So basically, I mean, originally, smoking is not allowed. It is prohibited. And with regard to fasting and smoking, it will invalidate the fasting of the person. So the person should avoid it in order not to invalidate his fasting. So today we have talked about these rules. We talked about the siwak and the toothbrush. And we talked about using the creams and smelling the perfume and the incense, as long as the person does not inhale the smoke of the incense. And we talked about smoking and mentioned that it will invalidate the fasting of the person. These are some rules, and we'll continue, inshallah, next time with some more rules related to fasting. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our fasting, our recitation of the Quran, our qiyam, our ibadah, our worship. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all our righteous actions and good deeds. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of us from those who listen to the words and follow the best of them. Jazakum Allahu khayran. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Wal asr. Innal insana lafi khusr. Illa alladhina amanu wa amilu assalihat. Wa tawasaw bil haqqi wa tawasaw bil sabr. Jazakum Allahu khayran. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.